Galveston. What, are we gonna ride rides there? At Pleasure Pier? Oh wow. Come over here and tell me. Oh, you're gonna be a police car, alright. Avery, look this way. Hi, Mommy. There's Daddy. Avery, look at those rides. Look at log ride, we should do that. The log ride's not scary. Oh, there's a boat like at Six Flags you went on, Avery. Yeah.
When will you get it?
Huh?
I said, when is Daddy gonna understand? His daughter.
I got her to do it.
She hated it. She cried the whole time.
She's proud afterwards. I have to go on that.
I'm gonna go to
Oh wow. Over the ocean? Oh, look at all those pelicans. Avery, keep dancing. What are we about to do?
Are
you
a little
bit nervous? Okay. Here we go. Oh, we're going so high. Look at the view. Oh. Look how high we are, Avery. We're at the top of the Ferris wheel.
We are at the top.
Yeah. Look at all those people on the beach.
See, somewhere down there is our penthouse. Somewhere down there.
So I think last time we came, it was like Sunday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, so the beach was less crowded. Look at all those people on the beach. There's Avery. We are on the Ferris wheel in Galveston, Texas. August 7th, 2020.
Daddy is about to be an old man.
Yep. Less than a week.
last 2 days in his 30s.
Daddy will be a big 4-0 over the hill. Other people on the Ferris wheel, there's mom and baby. Hotel Galvez, we stayed there last year. Way down yonder is San Luis and Arlington.
No,
the what? Penthouse. Alright. Okay, we'll continue videoing later. Where are we?
Hello, we're getting on
the
ferry.
All right, there you go. See, look, that's it. All right, get ready to go on. See all those colors? See, look. Avery, come here. Can you see? We are going. Here, let me pick you up and I'll show you. Hey, look at the camera. If you want to be able to see where we're going, look. Look, see, we're not on land anymore. Can you see or you want me to pick you up? Huh? Happy legs. Look, see? We're not on land anymore. See, look, we're on the ferry. What do you think? Pretty cool, huh? Back on, then we'll head back. We're going to this island over here.
see where that smoke's coming out? That's where they're making, they're refining oil to make gasoline.
Look, and there's another ferry boat. What do you think about that? Big cargo ships? I don't see any cruise ships. Pretty cool, huh?
are we? Look at me. See any dolphins out there?
They're over there.
Oh, there's some dolphins. We'll see some dolphins coming up here. See Avery? Come on, dolphins. Galveston.
This is not Galveston.
We're almost there.
But it's just what's
called. Huh?
But it's just what's called.
This is the Gulf.
Hello, we're doing a sandcastle lesson.
Alright, let's go find out.
Hello.
We're at the sea. We're going to learn how to build that. Are you excited, Avery? Where are we right now?
At the beach.
Where? What city?
Galveston.
Galveston, right.
On a process that you can use to make a really cool sandcastle. So this demonstration takes 10 or 15 minutes, something like that. And then once it's finished, if you want to work on your own project, you're going to have access to some of the equipment over here to make your own. If you like. Normally I just wait for the helicopter to go by. Okay, so basically there are two different parts to making a sandcastle. First there's building, and then there's carving. So we're going to start by talking about a few different ways that we can make some really solid structures of sand, and then after I build something up, I'm going to show you how you can carve it so it looks like a castle. Alright, so that's the basic process we're dealing with today. This is how I normally start. I just start with a pile of sand. Your pile can be just about as large as you want it to be. Obviously, if you want to make a larger castle, start with a bigger pile than this. I wouldn't start too much smaller than what I have going on right here. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to turn this pile into a foundation. So I'll start by pushing the sand around and just sort of looking for a flat surface that I want to build on top of. Once I've found a level surface, I'm just going to pack it down with my hands like this. So this is called soft packing. It is the most basic way to compact sand. You've probably done this yourself before. Soft packing can be good for lots of different things. Say you've got you like. If you cut the bottom out of a bucket totally soaked, we'll take our hands out, grab the top edge of our form, wiggle on it like this, and then I'm gonna gently slide it up for us.
Look.
So now we have solid sand forming underneath here, and we're also creating more space so we can fill it up. Okay?
All
right, let's do that a few more times. So we're gonna grab some more sand. Hands is the shape the sand is going to want to take. So if we keep our surface flat, it's going to be a lot easier to keep on building upwards, and they're also going to stick together a lot better. Also notice that as I'm stacking, I'm being very, very gentle with the sand. So we don't ever want to try to pound or pack the sand into place. All we do is set it down very gently, apply a light jiggle, and then let the water do the rest of the work. If we try to compact the sand ourselves, it's not going to work, first of all, and more than likely, you're just going to undermine your foundation by hitting it too hard or sort of shaking it. So, once again, just let the water. We're going to build a sandcastle. All right, final thing, once we get up a little bit higher, eventually we want to start to use smaller handfuls of sand. So we want our tower to gradually taper off like that. We do that just to make sure we have less weight on top than we have on the bottom. Our structure is going to be stronger if we build it this way. I'm tapering off pretty quickly right now. You don't have to go quite so fast. If you want a larger structure, just keep it wider for a bit longer. And you'll end up with something a little wider and taller in the end. Okay, so I want to show you all one more hand stacking method, and then we can move into some carving. So this next hand stacking method is the brick laying method. We can use these bricks to do a few different things. We could use them to make walls. We had another tower here and we wanted to connect them up. We could build a wall using this method.
What day is today?
Saturday.
Do you know what month it is?
August.
What day in August?
Saturday.
Saturday, August 8th. All right, here we go. Changes color.
Yeah, swim without touching the bottom.
Don't touch the bottom. I'm gonna make sure. Keep going, turn them over.
Hey, keep going. There we go.
Good job, Avery. What do you say?
Yeah.
So I went swimming all by myself.
Avery's friend.
Duck your head. Oh, wow, Avery. Here. it's a waterfall over there that goes all the way down to here. Yeah.
Oh. Well, if you dunk your head down, we'll go look at the waterfall. Yeah.
Dunk your head in.
Okay. You don't have to go underwater. Just look. You go all the way back.
I do it. We have no guidance.
Oh.
Not a waterfall.
This way. This just from here, I want to start to give the rest of my tower a more interesting shape. I might scrape a little bit more sand away from my roof just to make it easier to visualize the next few steps. But the next thing I want to do is start carving balconies. To carve a balcony, I'm going to use the step cut. That's just a cut straight down, followed by a cut straight across. So I'm going to begin by spotting my knife right underneath my roof, and then I'm going to cut straight down, right into that big chunk of sand.
Start over. Where are we going to do at the beach?
Down the way.
Oh, is that going to be so fun?
Yeah.
All right, we'll see you at the beach. Mommy and Avery are in the ocean. Galveston, Texas. Sunday, August 9th, 2020. Avery's at the beach. She thinks. Oh, big wave. Here, let me see this hand.
Okay. Here you go. It's okay. It's okay. Step back a couple steps.
Turn sideways. Mm-hmm. Have her turn sideways. Avery, what do you think about the beach? Is it fun or scary? Whoa!
We're gonna go back a couple feet. We're in a good spot.
That's better. Now it's not so violent. Babe in the beach. Alright, there's mommy. Avery, you might fall over. Turn sideways.
Building right now. Are you building a princess tower? So pretty. They took a sandcastle building lesson yesterday. Now they're putting what they learned to use. Alright. No rest for the weary. Back to working.
Silly.
She owns it, right? Oh, yeah, girl. There's your car. confident log.
What if I have like one of those that like?
Alright, we're gonna take a left up here. Not here. By those plants.
We're gonna go sit on a rooftop, hopefully. So we're gonna try to go sit there. All the way up top if we can.
Oops. Burped on camera.
Okay.
Oh, you wanna go take a picture of that? To help you.
Yeah, I'll hold you up.
Start talking.
Arg, matey. Avery, what does a pirate say?
Arg,
matey.
All right, trivia players, you got 10 more questions to go in the game. Questions left in the game. So put your phones away if you're playing trivia. And then after that, it'll be the end of this game.
Other way.
We'll have another game at 8. Let's see what happens. You see the questions.
No, turn it another way.
They've been challenging. That's the only word I use. Okay, 30 point questions now. 30. Gal pals, you're in the game. You did it. Okay, these are worth 30 each. Number 21. She provides the voice of Ellie, the woolly mammoth in Ice Age, The Meltdown. Who's the voice of Ellie? Queen Latifah, Goldie Hawn, Bette Midler, Joan Cusack, or Britney Spears? Who's the voice of Ellie, the woolly mammoth?
You do.
What did you say?
Joan Cusack.
Pick the one you think it is.
Queen Latifah. All right, pick one.
9 teams in the game. You got 5 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Oh, turn those other way.
Queen Latifah. 30 points. Number 22. The most common type of bathtub gin was made with grain alcohol, glycerin, and what? Apple juice, avocado juice, mesquite juice. Juniper juice or pomegranate juice? What kind
juniper
of juice was it?
Or apple.
Okay, this is in the time when we didn't sell alcohol. It wasn't allowed. So you had to make
apple
your own.
Apple fermented pretty easily.
So you took grain alcohol, glycerine, and what kind of juice? Ugh. Well, you know what? If I'm just going to tell you, if you know what gin is made of, you'll know. 5 seconds.
Maybe
4, 3, 2, 1. Gin is made from juniper plant. So it's juniper juice. 30 points. Number 23.
I said we should have gone with here.
Most episodes of this TV drama went back and forth between two separate investigations. Which TV drama are we talking about? Law and Order, CSI, Everybody Loves Raymond, Without a Trace, or Crossing Jordan? Most episodes went back and forth between two separate investigations.
That's good, baby. Put it on top.
Oh, wow.
Pick that one out of that list. 9 teams in the game. Five seconds, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Wow.
Time's up. Correct answer, CSI. Number 24. A woman named Mary Alice Young commits suicide in the pilot episode of this series. 6 Feet Under, Grey's Anatomy, or Lost? Mary And let's see how we got. Which one you think it is? 5 seconds. 4, 3, 2, 1. Well, one show has to start with somebody dying. And
yeah.
Well, no, it's not. It's, I thought it was 6 feet under. It's Desperate Housewives. What's...
Good job, Avery.
All right, number 25. Orion's Belt is a group of three what? Galaxies, cloud forms, planets, stars, or nebulae. Orion's Belt is a group of three what?
Could be star galaxies, but.
You ready, everybody?
Yeah.
All right. I hope you didn't overthink it, because it's three stars in the Orion constellation. Boom, boom, boom. Three stars. All right, after, what is it?
4, 5 rounds.
Uncle, you got 400. Sammy, 55 has 380. We live here as 380 in second. And in third, PJLCMT.
We have 270.
Austin is honorable mention along with the Griswolds with 340. One more round, 5 more questions, each worth 30 points each. So it's not break time quite yet. We got 5 more questions. Number 26. The betta fish is also known as the blank fighting fish. The betta fish. You know what? I think it's beta fish. I don't think it's say beta. It doesn't look right. Anyway, is it the Siamese, the Norwegian, the Maltese, the Mexican, or Japanese? What kind of fighting fish is it?
Mexican. Japanese.
What kind of fighting fish is it? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It is a Siamese fighting fish. And if you get two of them, they will fight with each other. So just get one. Number 27, almost done. It was a major factor in the sinking of the Andrea Doria off the New England coast. What was the major factor? A kitchen fire, an iceberg, a hurricane, heavy fog, or an inebriated captain?
2-5.
What caused the Andrea Doria to sink?
Whoa, you did it! What?
Avery?
Which one caused the Andrea
Doria? Once you build something your style.
5 seconds. All right, the major factor was?
Build something your style.
Heavy fog.
Fog.
No.
She collided with the Stockholm in 1956. That was another ship. Even with state-of-the-art radar.
I think I did all the weather changes.
Number 28.
Once this is over, Thomas.
In addition to being a choral singing group, a chorale is a type of what? Accordion, festival, Protestant hymn, folk dance, or brass band?
Festival.
A chorale. It's a group of singers, but what else can it be? What else could it be?
Yeah, good
seconds.
Job.
4, 3, 2, 1. The correct answer, a chorale, I believe, is a hymn. Yep, a Protestant hymn for 30 points. All right, hang in there. It's almost over. 2 more questions. Number 29. Which oldie dance floor favorite includes choruses of boogie, woogie, woogie? What's it called? YMCA, Electric Slide, Macarena? Party Rock Shuffle or Good Time?
Okay,
I'll do one more. Can
you take this away so I don't eat anymore? Thank you.
I don't know, but maybe you do. Do your best. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Everybody's in. The correct answer? Electric Slide. It's electric. One more question in the game, and I've got this $25 gift card to give away. Number 30. Always and Forever was a hit album for Blank in 1986. When they threw in some music right at the end. Was it Vince Gill, Willie Nelson, George Strait, Randy Travis, or Ronnie Milsap? Oh, I'm thinking of another song called Always and Forever. Always and Forever.
Avery burped. Avery, I got the basement.
Let's see which one this is. Everybody's in. The correct answer? Artist Randy Travis. Always and Forever.
We didn't land. Guess we're not.
All right, everybody. That's it for questions. Here comes the winner. If there is a tie for first place, I'll break the tie. By giving you another question. Our winner is whoever's at the top of this list.
Not
Uncle! You've done it.
Uncle won.
Where's Uncle?
Uncle's your winner.
Uncle won.
Congratulations. Hey, guys. Congratulations, Uncle. You got the most points.
Yeah.
Let's see how it ended up. As well as in, awesome. All good score.
Hey, it's my turn. You need to sit on the other side of your water bottle, Avery. Scoot over more this way.
See, by holding it, you like...
You made it all unlocked.
No. It is within my right to change it. Because you
okay,
change.
You can change it.
Not yet.
Avery, you need to stay on the bench so you don't get hit. Oh, get your water bottle, hurry. And you need to sit on the bench so you don't get, the building doesn't smash you.
I will announce the teams in about 4 minutes and we'll get going on the game.
Alright, Avery. Really, really gently. Like, super gently.
Well, it's taller than you, Avery.
Adjusting things, cheater.
Mommy, let's see what's loose.
I was so good.
That is risky.
Oh, I didn't see that. That's not what I wanted.
All right, another cheat, but we'll let you have it.
All right, Avery.
Cheating again.
Okay. Avery, watch out.
Not a move I'd make, but okay.
What?
I said not a move I'd make, but okay.
How about you?
Be careful, be careful. That was super terrible.
Now it's
my turn.
I mean, it's our turn, yeah. Hang on, hang on.
Avery, you need to sit right there. This is gonna fall on mommy. Cheaters always win, Avery.
And Avery, is that one coming up?
Hey, look at that girl. Oh, pull that one out, Avery.
Avery, come on. Okay, super slow. Right here. Super, like, no, this one.
I guess I'll have one. Yeah. Hey, Avery, that's just not fair. I get ready to yell out, Jenga when it falls. You say Jenga. Avery, back up. Watch out, scoot over. Now stand over here, you're safe.
All right, here's our teams for tonight, the 8 o'clock game tonight. We live here! Yay! PJLCMD!
Thank you.
Superfly!
Superfly.
I don't know. Six Aminos.
Ah, Jenga!
Team Gal Pals.
I won!
You won.
The team formerly known as... What's that? That's their team name. Formerly known as... All right.
Where are we?
We at the wall. We at the ocean.
At the seawall. See, the seawall is right over there. Look. That's the seawall. See, that's the ocean there. What do you think, Avery?
I like it.
Pretty cool, huh? All right, we're going to go to that pier way over there. All right. Want to talk to the camera? Is this our last day on vacation?
Yeah.
All right. Avery, come over here. Let's walk this way. Stay on the path.
There's the baby pool. There's no pets allowed in the pool area. No pets allowed. There's the hot tub. There's a big pool where Avery is swimming all by herself. Yep.